Reasons why African Americans should return to Africa. Hello, Displorers! Welcome to another informative video presented to you by Displorer and thanks for watching. The transatlantic slave trade took a tour on the African continent, leaving many of its children in foreign lands and distasteful conditions. The search for the greener pastures was a second wave of the same kind of trade, where the continent's best was taken, or strongest people, as labor force. But the current trajectory of things and turn of events indicate that it is time for Africa's children to return home. Hence, in this video, we shall examine reasons why African Americans should return to Africa. If you are new here, welcome! Be sure to subscribe and turn notifications so you don't miss any of our videos. The rush back to Africa has been going on, but no words can explain to another African American the benefits and reasons to return to Africa than the testimonies of others who already live here. For this reason, we shall use mostly the reviews of those already living in Africa to illustrate the benefit. Also, even though all the countries in Africa have been receiving and will still continue to do so, we shall use Ghana mostly, given its well-documented and loud policies to bring back and welcome the sons and daughters of Africa living abroad back to the motherland. Liberal business opportunities. In Accra, Ghana are African Americans who have come from the big cities of San Francisco, Chicago, New York and many other cities to live in the small African city, many refusing to return. A new wave of African Americans is escaping the incessant racism and prejudice in the United States. And from Senegal, Ghana to the Gambia, communities are emerging in defiance of conventional wisdom that Africa is a continent everyone is trying to leave, given the population returning. It is estimated that between 3,000 and 5,000 African Americans live in Ghana's capital, Accra alone. From teachers in small towns in the West to entrepreneurs in the capital who say even though living in Ghana is not always easy, they feel free and safe. It was very run-down looking. A Brooklyn-born 28-year-old recalled of her first glimpse of the capital, Monrovia, on her arrival. But my feeling as I was walking along the city's main streets was a sense of excitement. It felt almost like an out-of-body experience to finally be in Africa. John is one of a number of African Americans moving to the motherland, some inspired by the recent Year of Return movement initiated by Ghana, 400 years after the first Africans were brought in chains to Jamestown, VA. Ghana has already given citizenship to more than 150 people of African descent, many of them Americans. Rapper Ludacris obtained Gabonese citizenship, as so did actor Samuel L. Jackson, after tracing his heritage back to the nation's Bantu tribe, even though they are yet to move there permanently. New Jersey couple Crystal and Jason Ward hope to make their move soon. We wanted to be in a place where we can bring our experiences to people who are going to appreciate it to help develop, said Crystal, 33, the owner of two women's clothing stores. The couple, who have one child, plan to visit Tanzania and Kenya as soon as restrictions permit, and possibly move to Africa forfeiting their US citizenship, given several of Africa's 54 nations forbid dual citizenship. But even in the case where they still can maintain their nationality, is moving to Africa a profitable bet for an African American? Sense of community. Many Americans who have moved to Africa so far cherish their newfound feeling of community. Some of their experiences include that of Catherine Kishimbo, who left San Diego for Tanzania, which she chose for its wealth of great landmarks, Mount Kilimanjaro among them. She is now married with a young daughter, and she says she loves how warmly she's treated. When they see Americans, 9 times out of 10, they are white, Kishimbo said. They are super surprised to see me. Kaylan Reid, a journalist who grew up in Mount Vernon, New York, has lived in Namibia for 10 years. And he also agrees, there is a comfort that comes with being around people who look like you and seeing people like you on billboards and in government positions, said Reid, 36. Safe haven from racism and diversity. Many, including Kishimbo now living in Tanzania, say they moved for their children because they see Africa as a safe haven from racism. She said Americans measure quality of life against Western standards. What our adopted country lacks is infrastructure and conveniences, she said. It makes up for in natural resources. If someone has a completely different way of life, we seem to frown upon it, but there's more abundance here than I've ever seen in my life, Kishimbo said. In my front yard right now, I have a mango tree, an apple tree, a banana tree and an avocado tree. Rukia McNair, 38, rejoices in a different kind of wealth. Originally from Pittsburgh, the relocation consultant moved to Tanzania with her husband and two children in September 2018 and loves how diverse Africa is. "I didn't want my children to grow up in the United States," she added. "It's something different when you get pulled over by the police and you don't have to worry about your life being taken. The ocean helps me fall asleep and wakes me up in the morning," says Mr. Thompson, an African-American retiree taking a stroll on the beach where palm trees shade handcarved canoes. "Where else can I live this close to the ocean? It would cost me millions of dollars." Mr. Thompson, a native of Maryland in the United States, retired to Ghana 11 years ago. He first visited the West African country on a tour in 2000. "I fell in love with Ghana and its people," he recalled during an interview with Africa Renewal. "It was good seeing black people, my people, in charge of the country." That trip took him to many attractions across the country. He is also happy how he will no longer be treated as a second-class citizen. Currently, there are around 200 million people in the Americas identifying themselves as of African descent, according to the United Nations. Millions more live in other parts of the world, out of the African continent, and in most cases they experience racism and discrimination, which in Africa will not be a huge problem. A feeling of belonging. Mr. Thompson is one of those 20 or so African Americans and other people from the diaspora of African descent who have found a home in this fishing community, attracted by the beaches, peace, and tranquility the town offers, away from the hustle and bustle of Accra. So many African Americans live now on this beach site for several reasons, whatever their motives. Ghana, the first sub-Saharan African country to shake off colonial rule 58 years ago, has become the destination of choice for the diaspora, looking for a spiritual home and an ancestral connection in Africa. While some returnees have gone through the emotional journey of tracing their families through DNA testing, for the majority who just come to visit or settle like Mr. Thompson, the feeling of being home on the continent is satisfying. "It's good to know that you came from some place and it's not just a figment of someone's imagination," he says. "Ghana is definitely home. I'm going to spend the rest of my days here." Miss Chamberlain, a former dentist, says while her native Jamaica is more beautiful, it is not as peaceful as Ghana. Right of abode. Ghana, from whose shores the majority of 15 million Africans passed into slavery, has invited its descendants in the diaspora to return home. The country has had a long history, from the days of its first president Kwame Nkrumah, of encouraging the return of persons of African descent to help with the continent's development. In 2000, the country passed a law on the right of abode, which allows a person of African descent to apply and to be granted the right to stay in Ghana indefinitely. And recently, the country set up a Diaspora Affairs Bureau under the Foreign Affairs Ministry to provide a sustainable link between the Ghanaian diaspora and various government agencies to achieve development and investment goals. As much as there is a need to feel at home, comfortable, and run businesses in a convenient environment, African Americans also need to return to contribute to the continent's development and growth in every way. This will involve social, economic, and political involvement, as deemed fit and according to the individual's capacities. Mixed feelings. Despite some initial setbacks, people of African descent continue to migrate to the continent, though not in the expected droves. And like Florindo Johnson, it is important to encourage more blacks to come. "Haven't flown in and out of Ghana for 9 years. Ms. Johnson, a Caribbean who lived in Chicago, is retiring in Ghana to operate her 6 apartments in Pram-Pram that she intends to rent out as holiday accommodations. "I really want black people to come and see for themselves. It is disheartening that a lot of black people don't want to come because of what they've seen in the media. Yet, white people come." Conclusion. The passage of time has made many African Americans to feel like coming to Africa is a far-fetched idea, but there are several reasons why they should return soon. Besides the warmth, peace, sense of belonging they shall have, starting a business for most of them will be easy, given government policies set in place to care for them. Besides, the independence of Africa will never be complete until all the citizens of the continent are truly free, leaving the African dream void of racism. There you have it, Displorers. Those were reasons why African Americans should return to Africa. Thanks for watching this video, and if you did enjoy this video, do well to give it a thumbs up, do not forget to subscribe and share with your friends.